these puppies molt up?
A lot hotter than premium unleaded.
These weren't bombs.
Too much heat. I think somebody popped a little additive into the gas tank.
Really? Some of these bodies are nothing but dust. Gas fire can burn human bones, but not this fast.
Nitrogen, methanol, maybe some kind of liquid form.
Designer explosives are like computer software. Get one now, it's obsolete tomorrow. This was probably a home-cooked dealie.
Well, I need some leftover so I can figure out what was in the dealie.
You got it, babe.
Hey there. The head of security for Vectrochem says the guards patrol the last once an hour, and that basically people come and go, but there's a free-for-all at the change of each shift.
We had 23 fatalities, about the same injured. Some of these cars have 2-3 people each.
I want names and full backgrounds, and a complete list of Vectrochem employees.
Got it.
What are you thinking?
Whoever did this probably knew about that camera.
Could be a disgruntled employee. It's a terrorist group. They'll be calling the New York Times.
The tape will tell us if they chose the cars at random or specifically.
Whoever it was, they sure made their point.
Whatever that point is. The killings were random. The only cars picked were those where the gas caps weren't locked.
Drug companies have a lot of political and ethical enemies. How does Vectrochem rate?
It's no exception. They have ties all over the world. They manufacture an abortion pill in Denmark, experimental drugs for human cloning, and just a whole slew of stuff that's tested on animals.
But still, why kill 23 people at random?
It isn't random. His rage is directed at Vectrochem or something that they were involved in. The people and the company.
Exactly. So why not blow up the plant?
We can always build another plant.
Let's check for threatening letters. Anyone who may have a big lawsuit against them or any groups that could take a position against Vectrochem.
I spoke to their personnel. They have 800 people at the Atlanta plant. So far, nothing, but they're getting back to me.
You and Marcus get back to them. I've already had 4 calls from Washington. The director wants answers ASAP.
Anybody want a crash course in chemistry?
What do you got, Grayson?
Some very nasty homebrew. It's called thermite. Looks like sugar, but it packs a wallop that isn't so sweet. Unfortunately, any kid with a C-minus in lab can whip it up in a couple of minutes.
Powdered aluminum and iron oxide.
Equal portions, and it will melt the cockles of your heart.
It'll melt the cockles of anything. This stuff burns at 2200 degrees centigrade, half the temperature of an atomic explosion.
How's it ignite in a gas tank?
I figure it's liquefied, maybe with a little nitroglycerin. The car starts, the gas goes splish splash, and boom.
Hell on wheels.
You wanted the effect to be huge. Emotional. Keep it right here.
Okay.
Got it?
Mm. Oh, that one's totally spoiled.
What do you mean?
Well, it's only half her face. And it's cockeyed.
So what? They look great.
Yours never came out like this.
Sometimes they would come out worse. This one day was my father's birthday, and I got him from here down. I got a great picture of his tie.
I wish I could take a picture of Grandpa.
You will. But look at this. I mean, these are great shots, Chloe. Look, I can tell that that's Angel, and it looks like she's having a ball.
A giggle fit. I said, say cheese, and she had a giggle fit.
Well, that's what makes a great photo. Great emotion.
But a giggle fit's so silly. You really think that's great emotion?
One of the better ones. I also think it's time for someone to go to bed.
Okay.
Uh-huh. Uh-huh. No, no. Listen, I gotta go.
Okay. Me too.
Bye.
Do you think that I spent enough time with Chloe?
What kind of question is that? Of course you do. Give her every minute that you have. What's going on?
Nothing. I was just thinking about my father.
How long has it been?
Since we actually talked? So.
Mm-hmm.
Long time.
You have no reason to feel guilty, Sam. You are not like your father.
think he ever felt guilty?
He should. He's got a granddaughter he's never even met. Doesn't seem like he wants to include his own family in his life. You really want to see him, don't you?
Yeah. Well, I think you should meet his granddaughter, don't you?
So why don't you call him?
Yeah, maybe I will. Oh, you're back.
Night.
Great. Thank you very much.
Sam, we gotta go. What's wrong?
Nothing. I just called my father's office in Portland, Oregon, and they gave me a number to reach him. It has a 404 area code.
He's in Atlanta.
Yeah. Apparently he has been for 4 months. Something's gonna change.
Okay, listen up. There's a transfer order to move Sharon to Leavenworth as soon as possible. I'd like to make a move before she's 1,000 miles away. George, take us to prison.
Atlanta Federal Pen, right in our own backyard.
Green areas are level one security, that's delivery, visitors. Yellow indicates level two, it's administrative offices, guard quarters, and the physical plant for the whole complex.
When anyone with half a brain and a little luck can crash level one and level two. Level three, the area in red, is a lot tougher.
Access requires photo passes and magnetic key cards. Codes are changed daily.
Now, after Jack snuck a rose to his girlfriend, we moved her here. Always 16, cell block 7A. The whole cell block is under video surveillance, and there are armed guards day and night.
He doesn't want her out. He wants her dead.
A couple of small tactical nukes ought to do it.
Unless he pays someone else to kill her. There's women in there that'll do it for lunch money.
No. Jack will want to do this himself.
Sam's right. He wants to embarrass us.
He's only going to try if he thinks that the security around her is pregnable.
Well, Sam and I have a plan. We want to dangle Sharon out in the open, away from her cell in the infirmary. Make it seem she's more accessible than she is.
The infirmary is only at security level two.
Which makes it too tempting for him.
That's what we want. Now, I've already spoken to the warden to max out security around the infirmary without being too obvious. How are we coming with this game Jack sent us? Any help?
Well, the computer disk version that he sent us makes no more sense than the board game. It's exactly the same. Best I can figure is it's just all luck.
It's a dare. He's going after Sharon, and we're supposed to stop.
You really want to play chess with this guy?
Why not? We have the advantage. We have his queen.
You know, I don't understand you. Every time you come here, you ask me questions.
Most of them you already know the answers to. And the rest you know I'm not going to tell you. So either you're really smart or you're really stupid.
I vote stupid.
Did Jack ever tell you why roses are his favorite flowers?
Are they?
He sent you one in here the other day. It looked like it scared you.
You're so obvious, it's pathetic. Exactly how many hours of the day do you spend watching me anyway?
Does it give you a sense of power? It doesn't bother me. You can't read my mind.
I don't need to.
Why do you think Jack sent me a rose? I think that he did it because he misses me. What do you think, Dr. Waters?
It's his way of saying goodbye to you. It's scary. Being cornered.
You ought to know. You were nothing until you got obsessed. You're still nothing. You don't have a clue. You're wrong! This is a game! And it's about to be over very soon.
You're in love with him, aren't you, Sharon?
I'm sick of talking to you.
The rose is Jack's favorite flower. Because it's my favorite flower.
Maybe you should be dead!
She thinks that Jack is gonna come and save her.
Fairy princess locked in a tower, waiting for her Jack in shining armor.
It's too bad we don't have more time. I feel like I could get through to her.
Problem is, any day now they're gonna ship her to Kansas. We'll have less control there. I think we have to make our move, put her out in the open.
Billy, we got a hot one. Guy called from Eldon, Missouri. He's connected to Vector Kemp. Says he just spoke to the guy who torched the parking lot.
Let's settle up.
It was the most frightening thing that's ever happened to me.
Mr. Brandywine, what's your connection to Vector Kemp?
I'm in the import-export business. I export their products, mostly to Africa and the Mideast.
Could you tell us about last night?
I was down at the Lake of the Ozarks. I keep a bass fishing boat there. I came back just before dark, and he was waiting for me in the garage with a gun.
Who was waiting?
It was a man. I never saw his face. He wore this black hood over his head. It was like an executioner's mask. But I could see his eyes, sharp, clear. It was like an eagle's or a hawk's.
Did he say anything?
He told me to be quiet and to come inside, and he had a pistol.
Did you recognize his voice?
No. I'll never forget it.
Would you mind walking us through what happened?
Okay. We came in here. He had already put a kind of, it was a kind of a mat on the floor.
Kind of mat?
Like the kind they use in school for wrestling matches. It was the size of a beach towel. The strangest thing, in the middle of it, sticking up, was a sparkle stick. You know, like kids use on the 4th of July, but longer. He made me kneel down on the mat. And he told me that he wanted me to confess.
Confess to what, Mr. Brandywine?
My worst sin. And he told me that I had 10 minutes to think about what I was going to confess, and then I'd have 60 seconds to confess it. He said if it was honest, I'd receive forgiveness and absolution. I didn't know what to do. My worst sin?
Did he try to help you, point you in any direction?
I begged him to. How do you know what somebody else thinks is your worst sin? I mean, where do you start? And he said that I was wasting my time, and that if I didn't confess, I'd receive retribution, the retribution someone deserves for not realizing the sins that they've committed. I didn't know what to do. My whole life started racing in front of me. 60 seconds. I mean, I'm 43 years old. I have a wife and two kids. I've never killed anybody or hurt anybody intentionally. Finally, he said that it was time to start.
I had an affair. I cheated on my wife, but it was only once. A woman I met in San Francisco. My God, I don't even remember her name. I cheated in the business. I lied about money and expenses. I fired people, the people I thought were stealing from me. I couldn't prove it, but I've done things I'm not proud of. Unethical things, immoral things. My God, what do you want me to say? What can I say? I've cheated customers, exported products that weren't authentic. Fake artwork, knockoff clothing, drugs that were diluted, not the strength they were supposed to be.
It was the Vetrochem deal he was waiting for me to confess, and telling him saved my life.
What was the Vetrochem deal?
It wasn't illegal, maybe unethical. Vetrochem manufactures a cholera drug at full strength. It's effective. But for years, they would ship light versions to the Third World. The pills looked the same, but the doses were only 10%. They charged full price, and it cost just a fraction. I exported a batch of it to Sierra Leone.
There was a cholera epidemic there.
Less than a year ago.
Killed a lot of people.
Those drugs were manufactured at the Vetrochem plant in Atlanta. Now, the reason I think that this
executioner.
Yeah. The reason I think this executioner killed those people down there is because before he left, he told me that pretty soon the whole world would know about the root of all evil.
Love of money.
Is there anything else, Mr. Brandywine?
Yeah. He tape recorded it. He took it with him.
Okay. Why kill 23 people in Atlanta and let this guy live?
Because he confessed.
How the hell did he know what Brandywine was going to say? He didn't give him any clue it was about Vectrican.
Well, the executioner knew what his crime was. This whole ritual is about getting him to confess it. Confessions have to be sincere. They have to be from the heart.
On a wrestling mat with sparklers burning. Now what?
So, how are my favorite federal musketeers?
Not great, Ben. How about you?
I'm a better. I mean, usually, find a homicide, it's a dead body with holes in it. It's like tapioca sprinkled with ketchup. No, this is a whole new recipe. Somebody turned one Austin Greenberg into a human barbecue right in the middle of his own roof. Ashes to ashes, dust to dust.
Fire out here. How come no one called the police?
In New York? Hey, somebody finally did. And since this particular form of ending the human experience is rather unique, I checked with VICAP. Bingo. We got Vectrochem, Thermite, FBI, et cetera, et cetera.
Who was he?
Austin T. Greenberg, certified public accountant. 34, no wife, no mob connects. No record whatsoever of being a bad boy.
This guy certainly isn't wasting any time, is he?
Who?
The executioner.
Oh, he's got a nickname already. Cute.
We have a man in Elder, Missouri, who was forced to make a confession at gunpoint by a man wearing an executioner's mask. His sin was that he sold a watered-down drug made by Vectrochem to a country suffering a cholera epidemic.
Mario, did you get that copy? Thanks, man. Found this near the body. Now, personally, I like Cole Porter, but if you're into hysterical confessions, this will be right up your alley.
Find anything connecting Greenberg to Vectrochem?
Nope.
Did Greenberg have any corporate clients?
Yeah, a couple of dozen. I'm faxing you guys everything.
I like the forensics on the thermite and all the background information on Greenberg you can give me.
Yeah, you got it. And you, you're looking good.
Gee, thanks.
I don't know what you want!
Your confession. If you want to be forgiven, you have to confess. The world will know your sins very soon. And the root of all evil.
I had the St. Louis office play a copy for Brandywine. The ID'd the voice is the same one who forced this infection.
The hissing is the sparkler. They're full of magnesium, which is an effective way to set off thermite.
In New York, forensics also found trace of inhibitor chemicals. The mat must have some kind of second layer. After the thermite burns, it puts itself out, otherwise the whole apartment would have gone up.
Brandywine confessed the sin the executioner wanted to hear. He lived.
Evidently, Greenberg blew his shot.
Yeah, but for what?
The love of money, root of all evil. The punishment for which is the fires of hell.
So basically, we're looking for some self-appointed biblical angel who's sitting in judgment on those who love money.
Then why go after the people in the Vectrochem parking lot? They had nothing to do with the whole bad drug deal.
Because they were a part of the way to let the world know.
So maybe this guy has relatives in Sierra Leone, somebody who died from the cholera epidemic.
Maybe. So far, there's no connect between Greenberg and Vectrochem. Most of his clients were law firms.
Well, there's your root to all evil right there.
Greenberg may have committed another sin.
And I have put all these elements together. He had to have this in mind for a long time.
Well, there's no doubt that the anger is deep-rooted. Question is, how wide is it spread?
Marcus, go over the hate mail again.
Cool. I'll take you back another 5 years.
John?
Yeah? Stay on the Vectrochem people.
Georgie, I want to know about every client and tax return Austin Greenberg ever worked with. We may find the link. Good. I'm well aware the media isn't a feeding frenzy, sir. We're doing everything we can. All right, sir. Thanks for the heads up on that new information from Interpol. Bye. How's my girl?
Great. Guess what? Do you remember how I applied for a mission at Marion State? I got in. But that's not even the good part. We got a scholarship, $10,000 a year for tuition, room and board. Can you believe that? What? What's wrong?
I don't want to burst your bubble. There's a little problem. Under the terms of your probation, you're not allowed to leave Atlanta.
Not even for school?
Technically not for any reason.
They can't do that. I applied and I got accepted.
The judge can do whatever she wants, Franny.
Then we have to talk to her. I mean, we can both talk to her. I mean, this is a once in a lifetime shot, Dad.
Don't worry. I'll make it happen.
Done deal?
Done deal.
Started cramping.
Well, let's have a look. Have you been feeling all right lately? Any other physical problems we should know about? No? Okay. Well, let's enter. Her.
Jersey police reported three more victims of the executioner. All three worked for Vectorchem. The last two were killed in Europe. Philip Gunter, a courier in Brussels. Eric Blair, a sales rep in Amsterdam. The other was a customs and immigration consultant, Barbara Parsagian. Her remains were just discovered.
All three of these people were killed before the parking lot?
Yeah, and the MO was an exact match. Now, with these two overseas, and all within the last week, we didn't know we had a pattern until now.
He's working from outside the drug scam inn. First a courier, then a sales rep, then a customs official, until he finally gets a confession out of Brandywine, the exporter. So everyone is culpable, everyone is responsible.
Now, whoever this guy is, he's mobile. He knows how to investigate, or he knows someone who has access to the information.
Could be FDA, somebody at Justice. I'll get on it.
Point is, none of these people were high profile at Vectorchem.
Yeah, the people in the parking lot weren't even low profile.
Working for Vectorchem is enough.
He's killed 27 people we know of. We can't even find a damn connect between Greenberg and Vectorchem. So we might be moving on to another target.
Yeah, Grant.
George, any idea how we might let the world know in an even bigger way?
I'm already searching the net. I'm using keywords like root of all evil, variations on that.
Got it.
Bailey, another confession. A woman named O'Hara in Philadelphia.
Let's go.
I was so scared I could hardly talk.
What was he waiting to hear you confess, Miss Sawyer?
It was Transpocor. I know it had to be. It's the parent company of Sky Atlantic.
The commuter outfit. One of their plans went down a couple of months ago.
On Long Island. There were 8 people on board, but it hit an apartment building. 84 people died.
I remember that.
What did you have to do with it?
I'm the secretary for the CEO of Transpo Corp. We bought the airline just before the accident. Our plan was to turn it into one of those no-frills airlines. We figured we could cut our costs and run it at a higher profit margin.
You think the crash had anything to do with the cost cutting?
We cut back on some maintenance procedures. But it was completely within the law.
Mrs. O'Hara, after your confession, did he talk to you?
He said I was forgiven for my sin. And then he wanted to know all about the purchase of the airline. I told him everything I could. He said money was the root of all evil. And then he said, Very shortly, the whole world would know.
The Trespo Corp buy the airline strictly for profit.
Actually, we're taking it public. We've set up seminars aimed to attract small investors.
Can we see a schedule of those times and addresses?
I have one right here. Basically, they meet somewhere, then bus the people to the airport so they can have a look at the Sky Atlantic operations.
One of these sales meetings is happening right now in Chicago. Preliminary indications are the thermite was right in the middle of the bus, set off by a timer. These victims never had a chance.
43 people whose only sin was they might buy shares in an airline?
His retribution is general. Anybody even remotely connected is as guilty as the people who ran Sky Atlantic.
We'll have bios and personal data on all the victims by the time we get back. Probably a dozen calls from Washington. Sam, we got the Greenberg connect. He did some accounting for Transpo Corp before they bought the airline.
Great.
Worth a thousand words.
And this one.
The whole story in a dozen shots.
I remember this. She lost her parents in the Sky Atlantic crash on Long Island.
The photographer said that it was all in her face, that old tragedy in her poor little face. I never could have done that.
Done what?
Oh, I thought about being a photojournalist when I was in school. I never could have taken that picture. I would have dropped my camera and put my arms around her instead.
I know what you mean.
I keep trying to figure out what this means to him. I mean, it's highly unlikely that he was a victim of both disasters, and he didn't see it on TV or just read it in a newspaper.
Well, planning is too specific. Well, something triggered him, and he's done his homework.
It's almost as if he's picking people removed from the heart of the situation. Like we are when we look at these photographs. I mean, they make us cry. But it's not the same thing as actually being a part of it.
We're part of the emotion, but removed from the reality.
Right. He's telling us that the root of it is money.
Drug company in Atlanta waters down its product. People die in Sierra Leone. An airliner tries to improve its profit margin and distant consequences.
Sin is greed, but the result is far away, detached. That's what he hates, that detachment. People doing things and never realizing the consequences they have on people thousands of miles away. But he knows what that emotion is like. He feels it.
So what kind of person murders because of it? Humanitarian, Red Cross worker, someone who's close to this kind of situation day in, day out.
Maybe some sort of idealist, because nothing is ever ideal.
For any of us. Let's pick this up tomorrow.
Yeah.
Good night, sir.
Good night, Malone.
Hello, Samantha.
Hello, Father.
Good to see you.
I got the message you called. It's good to see you, Sammy.
Nobody's called me that in 25 years.
Good. It makes me feel unique.
It's all this gray.
Too many late nights like this.
Still working too hard.
The diseases never rest, neither should research. And I have a paper to present to the center tomorrow morning.
Oh, well, I didn't mean to intrude. I knew that you were here, so I just wanted to come by and see you.
How's Chloe?
She's great. She's great. She's growing like weed. She's gonna be tall, like you.
And Angel.
Angel is good. She's finally starting to sell her paintings, sculpture. She's doing well.
And you?
I'm good. I'm getting there, yeah. How about you, Dad?
Well, the viruses are spiraling out of control, mutating like kernels of corn starting to pop. It seems every time I isolate one, 6 months later, it's changed. You blink, and the world is different.
Sometimes I think we blink and half our lives are gone. All right, look, I guess it's not gonna be tonight because you're busy, but at some point I would like to get together with you and have dinner, some time when we can talk when you don't have a research paper breathing down your neck.
Absolutely. How about Thursday?
Thursday would be great. You can have dinner at our house.
Oh, good.
It's really good to see you, Dad.
Proud of Franny, Sam. All the hard work she's put in over the last 2 years and all this, she's come a long way.
Well, give her my congratulations.
I want to hold off celebrating until I talk to the judge.
What are you going to say?
I have no idea.
Billy, Sam, I think we hit pay dirt, but I'm not sure what it means.
The root of all evil is at the heart of our society. Death is fair retribution for the love of money and the pain and suffering on the faces of innocent people. Soon the world must know.
It's the same phrasing as the tapes. Sam.
Where'd you find this, George?
Cyberspace. I searched the internet using those keywords we talked about. It's been posted to dozens of news groups all over the planet. It's impossible to trace, and it's being retransmitted exponentially.
So hundreds of thousands of people are reading this.
Millions.
He's gearing up.
Another confession. About 4 this morning, Montgomery, Alabama. A guy named Leonard Jalacki's a weapons dealer.
Stay on this, George. Let me know if you find anything else.
Son of a bitch got me right here. I just got back from an 18-hour flight. Dubai to London, New York, Montgomery. He must have known. He couldn't have gotten inside.
What was your confession, Mr. Jalacki?
Confession? Yeah, that's a good way to put it. I would like to find that little piece of garbage and hear a confession on his part. Look, I don't break the law. I sell weapons, legal, licensed.
To whom?
Mostly foreign entities. Whatever the hell they do with him is their business.
Mr. Jalacki, you must have told him something specific. Something that stopped him from killing you.
ABX. ABX Armory.
Landmines.
Yeah.
Who does ABX sell them to?
The Middle East, Africa, Asia. They all want a new world.
Along the way, they plant landmines.
First, they want to kill everybody in the old world, and they don't do such a good job of cleaning them up.
Innocent people die.
It's not a good thing.
Where is ABX located?
Mobile. I should be there right now. Weapons expo at the Benson James Hotel. I will probably lose a lot of business.
Excuse me.
Command Center, freely.
George, I want you to check out a place called the ABX Armory. Their weapons deal is located in Mobile, Alabama.
They're supposed to be having a sales expo at the Benson James Hotel.
Got it. Just take me a couple seconds. Bailey, I don't believe what I'm seeing. At Benson James Hotel, I think the executioner just did a whole room full of people and he's showing it live on the internet.
Tell John and Marcus to get there now.
President's going live from the White House in about an hour. They say they're gonna want to do a briefing from the scene.
I can't breathe in here.
Going outside to get some air, man. I'll take care of this.
You figure our pension plan has any stock in ABX Armory? That's what it takes for this guy. These people work for the company every day. If they knew they had stock in ABX. Bad luck.
Look, John, you gotta stay focused, man. Nobody's equal to something like this. And I pray to God we never get that way.
You ever think about working a plane crash? Big jet goes down, you're first on the scene. Bodies, wreckage all over some godforsaken hillside.
Yeah. I know. It's like taking a walk in hell.
You take that walk?
Incendiary was thermite. He used some kind of extinguishing agent in a ring around the displays.
They say the firestorm lasts about 20 seconds, just enough time to suck all the air out of their lungs like a pump.
I was wondering why there weren't more burnt bodies. I hate it too, John. But the only way I can deal with it is to concentrate on the individual who caused it. We do that, we can stop them.
I'm gonna try Grandpa one more time.
I don't think he's coming.
You know, maybe he got stuck in traffic or a meeting ran late.
But he would have called.
You know what, Angel, I think that you're right. I think he probably got stuck in traffic or he got stuck in a meeting or something like that. Yeah.
He doesn't want to meet me.
That's not true, Chloe. Grandpa's just a very, very busy man.
Maybe excuse, please.
Yes, you may.
I don't care if I never see him.
You know, I really hope, for his sake, your father's got a good excuse.
I wouldn't count on it.
Love me and want to see me and go places and do stuff. Won't you?
Of course I will, Chloe. You're my daughter. I'm always gonna love you.
But if you're his daughter, how come he doesn't love you?
He does. In his own way, he does. George.
Good morning.
Black, please.
Here, take this one.
Thank you. Well, I was thinking about our executioner. He seems to lock onto these disasters that get major media coverage.
Yeah. So far, it's things everybody knows about. Maybe he's a news junkie. And at the very least, what he did on the internet tells us he has to know something about communications.
Yeah. He seems to have a passion for the human results of those events. It's almost like he wants everybody to see his passion.
We looking for a reporter?
Maybe, but I think this guy's really visual. I think he could be a photographer, cameraman, a director, maybe even a publisher.
So you want me to cover the world?
Yes, I do.
No problem. Take a few minutes.
Thanks, George. I'll see you in a minute. Ed Turley, he was pinned down on the Gulf War for weeks.
Turley's deceased. He died 6 months ago.
Margaret Eddy can't stay.
It's amazing how one photo can just take you right there. The whole era, the songs, the emotions of it.
George, wait a minute, stop. All of these photographs. Where does your eye go?
To the faces.
Exactly. What was it the executioner said? All the pain and suffering on the faces of the innocent people. Let's concentrate on the photographers who covered these events, especially those who captured the emotion of the moment in faces.
All right.
We're gonna have to find out where all these photographers are now.
Okay, take another few minutes.
I owe you, George. Philly, I have a question for you. What's the matter?
Judge Perelman said no to a change in Franny's probation. She won't let her leave town to go to college. She worked hard, Sam. This is going to break her heart.
Judge wants you to admit that Frances took your gun deliberately, right?
If I told her the truth, Franny would be in jail right now instead of winning a scholarship.
Maybe, but...
I committed perjury. I admitted she'll nail me to the wall. Even if I don't go to jail, they'll kick me out of the bureau.
Well, you should have called, Dad. I mean, Chloe was really looking forward to meeting you.
I didn't mean to upset everybody, Sam. But the presentation got pushed. Then the International Red Cross called. They need some of my research. It's hectic. I'm even late for a symposium tonight.
You know, you were always hectic. As I recall, it's been hectic now for about 20 years. You were the most hectic man in America. It isn't so much that you broke the promise to me, Dad, but it's not fair to Chloe, you know? It's just, it's not fair.
I'll make it up, Sam. I will. Just tell me when.
Well, I'm not sure. I'm gonna have to get back to you on that.
Thanks. See you, Sammy.
Sam, everything you wanted to know about photojournalism circa 1965 to the present. Now, I've been sorting the work by topics and nationalities of the journalists. These would be the most high-profile ones.
Do we know where they are?
That's tough, because, you know, these people are gypsies. They live out of their suitcases. Seven are currently on known assignments out of the country, so that leaves these five.
Can you show me some of their work?
Yeah.
The faces tell the story. I tell you what, I'll take the first three, you take the last two. Let's make some phone calls, see if any of them know anything about Vector Cam, Sky Atlantic, or ABX Armory. Thanks, George.
All done. You can look now, Sharon. So how are the cramps? Any reoccurrence?
Last night I felt like I was gonna die. Look, whatever you're giving me, it's just not strong enough.
Okay, I'll increase the dosage. I suspect that you've picked up a abdominal parasite, which is hard to pin down. So until I can figure out what the problem is, I'm gonna have them bring you down here twice a day so that I can draw blood samples.
Look, that's a lot of blood.
Don't worry, you make more.
The human body only has 12 quarts.
You know, most people have no idea how much blood they've got.
My turn, Samantha. And you? You may you not get another one?
Hey, any luck?
No, I've spoken to 4 of the photographers so far. Yeah, they've all read about the execution in the papers, but nothing's jogging any memories.
Well, John and Marcus exhausted any direct connection to the targets. Humanitarian agencies are a dead end. Mm. Shoe leather. Sometimes it pays off. Most of the times, you just wear out your shoes. See you later.
Yep.
If you want to be forgiven, you have to confess. The world will know your sins very soon. And the root of all evil. And the root of all evil.
What do you got?
James Davison lives in the loft, but his neighbors haven't seen him in about 2 weeks. He stopped his own papers and phones. We've got people on the back and on the roof.
I've got a warrant in place.
Yes, sir.
Thank you.
Powder and ferrous oxide. This is where he made his mats and sparklers. You don't find that stuff in a dark room. We're gonna have to confiscate all of his negatives.
We're lucky he left them. All his clothes are gone, no suitcases.
He's gone.
George, scramble the forensic team from the DC lab, top people. I'm gonna take this place down to the carpet tags. Check back.
You're not gonna find anything. This guy has honed his plan. He's perfected it. It's composed like a picture, everything in harmony of purpose. Really. This is him. This is Davis. Looks like a recent photo. He must have dropped his camera so he could help that girl.
The root of all evil.
What was it the photographer said? The whole story. It was all in her face, the whole tragedy. Well, Davison took the picture, but his editor, Will Cook, wrote the caption. We need to find out what happened this day. Maybe Will Cook can tell us. Mr. Cook, my name is Smith Waters.
I'll let him know.
Dr. Waters, I'm Will Cook.
Thank you for sitting.
My pleasure.
He's bringing back memories.
I know the feeling. Your office called about an hour ago. Still hasn't sunk in about James.
I'm very sorry. I just saw this whole series of photos in Davison's lock.
I put them there. I also took them. I used the camera James dropped in the grass when he went to help the little girl.
They're very powerful.
They were also luck. I'm strictly point and shoot. But even an amateur holds out from the sand trap every once in a while.
Yeah, I'd say you did more than hole out.
Not really. Mostly it was James. You might find this a strange thing for me to say, Dr. Waters, knowing the horrible things James has done, but there was a time when I hero worshipped him.
You worked with him for a long time, didn't you?
Nearly half my life. I considered it an honor to edit his books. When we first met, James was a camera nut, wandering Greenwich Village, taking pictures of the freak show. He'd only shoot faces, eyes mostly.
The windows to the soul.
Yeah. In time, it became a trademark. James Davison could capture a decade in a single portrait.
What do you think made him change?
Bodies broken into pieces. Blood so thick it covers the top of your shoes. I mean, how many times can you look into the face of a starving kid, snap a picture, and then go back to your regular life?
When he helped that little girl, was that the first time he put down his camera and stepped in?
First time I ever saw him do it. I think that was the final straw. That was the last assignment we worked together. He just sort of dropped out after that.
I guess it would be hard to be objective when you're surrounded by so much pain.
It's impossible. We talked about it many times over the past 10 years. I think James was looking for reasons.
Do you think that he was looking for blame?
He felt we were all to blame. In a way, he's right. Look at Biafra, Bosnia, Northern Ireland, our own inner city nightmares. We pay lip service, read the stories, look at the pictures, but what do we really do about it?
What do you think that he's going to do?
Something that will create images the world will never forget.
Mr. Cook, I need to get inside your friend's head, figure out what he's thinking, what his next move might be.
He was always wondering what it would be like to uncover a disaster before it happened, to actually prevent something instead of just chronicling the aftermath.
Could you do me a favor? Could you make a list of all the stories that James covered and the stories that he wanted to cover?
Okay.
Thank you very much.
You know what you'd find if you looked inside his head 20 years ago, Dr. Waters? Somebody full of midnight courage. Somebody you could call a hero. Somebody you would like. An awful lot.
Thank you, Mr. Secretary, delivery man, electrician. All with business in the infirmary where you keep Sharon.
The electrician could have wired the scoreboard at Madison Square Garden with the amount of time it took him to hook up one light.
It might have just been bolt breaking.
The delivery guy kept coming around to flirt with me.
These people only have level 2 security.
That means they can't get into Sharon's cell.
No, but they can get into the infirmary. Maybe our bait's working and it's luring Jack in. Hmm?
You don't think Sharon recognizes you?
Well, she doesn't seem to.
We've got guards on the guards. Maybe Jack sent one of these people in to gather intelligence for him. Building diagrams, schedules, personnel.
Want to haul them in?
Oh. They're more useful in play. Let's put them in the deep surveillance.
So what's the point?
The point is we're dangling Sharon out there in the infirmary. Maybe Jack will think he'll have a chance to grab her. It's all part of the game. We make a move, he makes a counter move. The trick is to be the one to make the last move.
Thank you.
I intend to major in English literature with a minor in psychology. I think the two subjects are complementary. Two viewpoints into the human soul.
You're interested in the soul?
Francis and I attend.
No, I'm asking her.
Yes, I am. I want to know how I could have been so angry at my father a year ago and so grateful to him now. Not because he let me live with him. He's not easy to live with. And not because he loves me. I didn't used to care. But something in his soul touched me.
You're not the same young lady that stood before me last year.
She's in a position to take advantage of a progress, Your Honor. We're asking you to change your ruling and allow her to do that.
Why not go to Atlanta JC and stay within the limits I set in your probation?
I think Marion's a better school.
Well, I'm persuaded by your sincerity, Francis. Or I'd like to be. But there's always been a very facile sound to the explanation. Your father says he was careless with his gun. Decorated agent. I'm not here to retry this case. But would you care to set anything straight? Either of you?
Last year, Your Honor, you gave me a Solomon's choice. My daughter's freedom hung in the balance of my career with it.
Truth is not a choice.
A parent has only one truth. The loss of a child is the one unacceptable thing. I defended Francis the way I had to. It wasn't a decision. It was a fact of life.
In plain language, you lied.
If I say that and I throw away my career, you may decide to put her back in prison.
No, I meant what I said. My ruling is on the book. It just wasn't based in fact, was it?
No.
I'm putting you on notice, mister. You are a sworn agent of this court. I will take full sanction against you if you ever lie in my court again. All right, Francis. You can go to Marion.
We're very grateful.
Justice does not have to ignore the truth, nor lack compassion to have a soul. Agent Malone?
Thanks for everything, Daddy.
Bhopal, desert storm, meltdown at Three Mile Island, San Leandro earthquake. James did some great work there.
He ever mentioned to you his obsession with what he called the root of all evil? Abuse of money, greed?
I know he felt he made a living off the misery of the world. It bothered him. I told him we have a responsibility to let the rest of the world know.
He ever publish anything of any substance that didn't utilize faces?
No, never. He's into people.
You think he realizes what he's doing?
He's basically a moral guy. He knows he's going to have to pay for what he's done. He'll probably take retribution on himself.
Just need to figure out where and how. Each act of retribution committed by Davison relates back to a disaster that he covered as a photojournalist.
Exporting watered-down vaccines led to a cholera epidemic in Sierra Leone. Sky Atlantic cut corners on maintenance procedures to increase profits, and 84 people died. ABX sells landmines, and innocent men, women, and children are maimed and killed. We know he was affected by the church burnings in Alabama.
Hate crime.
He was affected so much that he put down his camera to help that little girl. I think that moment was a stressor.
Yeah, but he's been taking out his retribution on greed, not hate.
It's more than greed.
It's about a society that is so dispersed and yet so interconnected that an assembly line worker in Atlanta can play a part in the death of a child in Africa.
Unwittingly.
Exactly. And that's the sin. He's telling us to pay attention, to accept responsibility. Don't buy products that contribute to the death of people on the other side of the world.
We're all sinners by that yardstick.
Well, that's what he's using.
Okay, if he's fixing blame on the entire society, how do we boil down Davison's work to figure out what's next?
I got a list of the stories that Davison covered and those that he wanted to cover from Will Cook. I've prioritized them the way I think Davison might, according to greed and immorality.
We'll liaise with Justice and the SEC. They may have investigations of corruption we can connect. For instance, like the watered-down drugs Davison connected with the cholera deaths.
Whatever it is, I don't think that we've seen the worst. He wants a spectacle. A message of retribution seared into our minds in a way that we'll never forget.
Can I help you?
FBI, we're looking for Mr. Costas.
He's right over there, sir.
Mr. Costas, I'm Bailey Malone, FBI, Dr. Samantha Waters.
How do you do?
Oh, hi.
We received a report James Davison came here and assaulted you. You were here alone?
Yeah, it was about 5 a.m. I mean, I'm often here at night culling lists of contributors, writing for support, that kind of thing.
Did he make you confess, sir?
NASA's putting plutonium into the tips of Atlas rockets. I mean, a rocket is a bomb with fins. One of them will explode, and soon you can kiss Cape Canaveral goodbye. Insanity.
What's your connection to NASA? What did Davison want you to confess?
I was an engineer at MIT. I designed the test that NASA used to approve the plutonium. I'm the guy that said it was a good idea in the first place.
Thank you. We'll put NASA on high alert, stand down any launches. Problem is, they have hundreds of facilities all over the world.
You know, Davison did a photo expose on cancer victims who live near plutonium plants.
I had a hunch you'd come after the government sooner or later.
Pipelines.
Where are they?
He doesn't say. But I think that as part of his planning, he had shots of the Vectorcam parking lot, the bus in Chicago, and the hotel in Mobile.
What do you got?
George, can you digitize and blow this thing up to the size of a barn?
No. It's pretty much out to the grain right now, yeah?
Yeah, it's a 35. It's not going to get much better than this. I think I was able to make out a partial word on this one. Looks like A-N-E.
Methane.
Natural gas. They pipe it in from oil fields all over the country. California, Louisiana, Texas.
Will Cook told me that one of Davison's last crusades was looking for disasters waiting to happen. One of those was a potential natural gas explosion in Houston.
I thought he was going after NASA.
NASA's mission control is in Houston.
Man, they got so many natural gas lines running under Houston, they're afraid there'll be a fire or an accident in the wrong place one day. They won't be able to stop the explosion.
An accident or sabotage?
Well, one of Davison's thermite pads could do it. It could take out the entire city, babe. Davison was looking for a disaster is waiting to happen, something central, vulnerable. That is where he'll do it.
You ever see a jigsaw puzzle of spaghetti? Take a look down there. This could be anywhere.
Where are the touch points? Where would he put an incendiary?
Well, there's 600 miles of pipes below Houston, all of it under pressure. You put a match to it anywhere, you got a blowtorch. You put it in the wrong place, lights up the whole city.
Can you pinpoint that spot?
We got 40 square miles down there. In places, there's 10 levels of pipes. We could be looking right at him, not see him in that maze.
Takes out the city on CNN. Sodom and Gomorrah prime time.
Can you shut down the city?
Almost. Got a good start at retrofitting the system with shutoff points for emergency. Now, it's not instantaneous, but with enough warning, we can limit the damage.
Do it. How long will it take?
About an hour for the whole shot. If you can tell me exactly where he places his charge, I can isolate that spot a lot faster, but you do it soon. Because if that maniac sets off his thermite around here, we're ghosts.
Downloaded a complete diagram of the gas transmission system from the DOE database. I'm trying to match the pattern of the pipes from Sam's picture, but the computer is projecting hours to replicate all possible matches.
We may not have hours, George. Goose it. I'll keep the line open.
He's here. He's never gone more than 24 hours between confession and retribution.
It's been 22 hours.
He also knows that he's a sinner. A mortal shouldn't sit in judgment over others. He's gonna confess today and kill himself, Gary. This guy thinks in images and pictures. He's already composed the image. Can I? George, yeah, have the computer search for long, straight lines of pipe.
Got it, but the picture we're working off of is a tangle.
It's a detail within a bigger scale, what you would see from about 1,000 feet up. Look for a spot that is balanced between parallel lines, like a frame.
Okay. Got it. Junction 77A.
Junction 77A.
Five major trunks, that would do it.
Let's go. John, we're on our way down.
All right, shut down 6D, 6E, 6F.
I got you.
Get it up!
Get
him up,
that's it! Let's go! Hey,
hurry! 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 Still down in there? Get that stuff!
Good map!
Shut it down.
All right, Ron Grader, shut down this whole Northeast squadron.
Yeah, shut it down now!
I gladly confess. I have sinned and ask forgiveness, but expect none.
It's burning.
Davison, put it out!
I have killed. We'll kill again.
I can take him out.
You wouldn't stop the fire.
How fast is your 50-yard dash?
My sacrifice is for all mankind.
Hey, bud, that sure smells good.
Are you talking to me?
You know, if it's for Lesher, I bet that she only eats the dessert.
Dinner for Her Royal Highness. Oh, Benny asked me to bring it in. See ya.
You can. Maybe the chef at Leavenworth's big on salt pork and beans.
Just leave it.
This is precious.
Meg got it all crooked. But Mom says candid shots are okay like this.
Yeah, I love it. Thank you.
Isn't that a great shot?
Oh, yeah.
Are you going to hang it on your wall or put it by your bed?
Hello, Sammy.
Yeah. Oh,
is this a good time? Oh, I guess you're in the middle of something. I could come back.
No, no, that's okay. I'd like you to meet your granddaughter anyway. Club? It's your grandfather.
Mr. Anderson, it's been a long time.
Yes, it has. And this must be Chloe. Hello.
Hi.
You look just like your mother did when she was your age. Pretty as a picture. And I'll bet you're smart, too.
I don't know.
Oh, yes, she is. She's much smarter than I ever was.
Well, then, you must be really smart.
Mom, could I take a picture of you and Grandpa?
Sure, I don't mind if your Grandpa doesn't.
You can have a picture. If I can have a hug.
Well, I'll go get the camera.
Try not to have a giggle fit on me, Dad.
Okay, now say cheese.
Cheese.
Yeah, I usually get a couple of shots like this when I load the film into my camera. All cattywampus.
You could cut off the bottom, trim the sides a little, put it in a frame. Nobody would know it was like this.
It's perfect. Just the way it is. Thank you very much. Just perfect.
I think it's wonderful.
Thank you, George.
They just found a dead guard at the prison.
Grace is on, too.
Grace, we're at the command center.
A guard's been killed. He was stabbed and hidden in an empty solitary cell. He's been dead a couple of hours.
Where is Sharon?
She's already up in the infirmary. They found his body an hour after she was sent up for her afternoon blood test.
It's Jack. He's made his move.
Phase two, Gracie.
Will do. Do I have to lie here all day? I was hoping we would get your lab results today, but maybe tomorrow. We can bring you to yourself.
Approaching D block.
She's passing six, moving to seven. I'll pick him up in 30 seconds.
Marcus, are you in position?
Ready for them, Bell.
I got him. I got Jack.
Sam, Sharon's loose.